Welcome back, everybody. We pay Fulani herdsmen 100,000 naira for each cow killed. Same with farmers, Governor. Okay, see, Basel. He said that they give Fulani herdsmen each cow when they kill, they will give them 100,000 naira for that. But when they kill our people, they don't give them anything. We don't want make una give us anything. We want make Fulani people leave Southeast completely. We don't want money from government of APC or from OKZ Paso or from Unayarudo or from Ohanezendigbo or from any governor in the Southeast or South-South or Southwest of that country. We want Fulani people evicted completely. Make all of them go back to Sambisa Forest where they came from. Giving money, meaning engineering these people to continue to kill our people. Paying our people, meaning say you they encourage the killings. Now the law when they for grand una go take stop this killing, not be money. Now action una go take stop this killing, not be money. Because if they give them money, now you see they encourage them. Like the way when FG they pack billions of from billions of dollars, they go give Fulani people. I mean they go give the Boko Haram people and the whole terrorists when they that country, including ISWAP, ISIS, and all of that. So, okay, say Bazo, they encourage killing. You cannot say you won't give Hesme 100,000. And again, when they kill your people, you know they compensate nobody. One of the governors from the Southeastern part don't talk, see, then would they give each family when they kill person, they will give them 50,000 naira. Then they sell person 50,000 naira. Then even goods is more expensive than person. More expensive than someone's life. We don't need money. Nobody need money. People need peace. And for that peace to reign, now the law of the land will not go to follow this thing. And the action behind it. Make we read, may not be like seeing now from this platform, all this thing they emanate from. Now waiting. This guy, what they call OKZ Ekpazo Denyan. Now they carry the content, my people, my viewers, all over the world. The problem of Fulani herdsmen and farmers continue as the government and leaders keep on looking for a permanent solution that will solve the problem involving the killing of farmers and others allegedly by herdsmen. Nigeria and their government and the FG and the leaders as a whole in that country, they don't get any permanent solution. Because this problem, decades problem, not be today, this thing begin happen. 2008, 2007, all the things don't happen. Till today, no permanent solution. Jonathan office of the problem. The Abuhari office of the problem. Nobody go fit solve this problem. The thing when go only solve the problem now disintegration. So these people, when they call government and the FG and the leaders and all that, now sweet mouth. Brother, now sweet mouth, they no go fit do anything. When they talk finish, then go back. Take for example, then tell us say SACS people. Say they're not going to allow them to operate again in that country. What thing happen after some few days? Even when they do the protest, SARS still they operate. Now SARS don't go back full time into the city. They do what they know best. That is killing innocent Nigerian people. Now him they know best. So these people, any word when they come out from their mouth should not be trusted by any reasonable person from that country they call Nigeria. Because now so promise that they promise and they not do nothing. Before you know, 2023 don't come. All this thing now to they advance the agenda to, you know, demoralize you, make sure say you not feel talk again about things when they happen. Then when you're quiet, okay, election done this. Now you're gonna come out. We love you, we love you, we love you, we will do this. At the end, nothing. The same thing will continue. Speaking on the issue, the governor of Abia State, Governor Okezie Ekpazo, has come out on live television station to open up on how his administration is looking to resolve farmers and herders' conflicts in his state. According to the governor, Okezie Ekpazo, why on channel? All this thing na channel television. Na channel television be the propaganda machine when they get in that country. Na channel television then they use. That is why you see, then they go channel television. Now only channel television in Nigeria. When government they go answer question. And those people when they channel television, they don't even they ask them anything. Channel television never one day air the killings where they kill people from the southeast. Even from their place when be Yoruba land. They know they air nothing. Now only when something happened to Fulani people, you will see that they will come out. They will invite Fulani people to come and talk. So who una they deceive? Una not fit deceive anybody again, channel television. Okay, say Pazo. The whole governors in Nigeria. Una not fit deceive anybody again. We know say na Miyati Allah they control all of una. We know say na Miyati Allah they appoint all of una to the position where una they. Even though say Okezie Ekpazo promise he will give 100,000 to people when they kill their families, each family according to them, nasty mouth. The 30,000 minimum wage they don't promise you not take win Uluru elections till today. You see anything? I say if you don't receive 30,000, make you come to my comment section. Maybe we know how they take pay you that money. All right. According to the governor, Okezie Ekpazo, why on channel television, His Excellency revealed that his administration has set up a team that will be looking into the farmers and herders conflict cases. The committee named Farmers Herders Resolution Committee is headed by the Commissioner of Police. The same people. The same people. The same police, the same army people. While speaking, Governor Okezie Ekpazo revealed that his administration pays a compensation of 100,000 in Naira for any cow that is killed on account of a misunderstanding between the farmers and the herders. 100,000 Naira also goes to the owners of farmlands destroyed by stray cow in the state. How can you be paying money for all these things? Somebody get rice farm worth millions. Cow go enter, eat up the whole crops when they the farmland. What millions, oh, ladies and gentlemen? Then Okezie Ekpazo will come out. You don't invest millions. Millions. Okezie Ekpazo will come out and give you 100,000 because cow go eat up all the whole crops when you get inside your farm. Or the whole yam, or the whole cassava, or the whole corn. Can you imagine? Can you imagine impunity, ladies and gentlemen? The only thing when we solve this thing, ladies and gentlemen, not be by paying anybody money, not by stopping the herdsmen, allowing these people to go back en masse to their states of origin. Now only that will solve the problem. Paying, even you are paying 1 million, it's not going to solve any problem. Okay, Zek Bazon. And besides, 100,000 naira is nothing. What are you? They talk about people now when they eat up their crops or destroy their farms. What about people when they kill? Because Fulani herders, they know they go without killing. Blood food their hands. Even the ones when they inside city. Like I said before, all of them, they plot the whole thing together. If you think, say, those ones, when they sell, maybe wristwatches and they do like, say, they don't know anything. Brother, they know something. Even more than people when they head us, when they inside farm. All na intel. By intel. Now, phone technology full everywhere. Now, by call, they organize themselves. Those people, when they inside city, now them was past the herdsmen people when they lead cow. So they got to go back to wherever they come from. That is the only thing that will solve the problem. Now, make I tell on another one will blow on our mind. Yesterday, in same Oyo State, some group of politicians, una know them, they be criminal politicians. Una know what they tell governor of Oyo State and Oyo State people. They tell Oyo State people, say, the only thing when they want to do now, when they want to do, when they go like see, when go happen, be see, they want to make the Oyo State people, Amotekan, make them, you know, bring in his men inside the security outfits. Already, we don't tell them, say, Amotekan, na political. Amotekan, not be real security like ESN. Now, Amotekan is being controlled by the IG of police. So tell me how I want to take work. So these people now they claim say to solve the problem when they get, I mean the those political group. Then they claim say to solve the problem now to bring in Esmin, because when then they evict Saraki and all those people, say not be only the indigenous do the job. See, it gets on Esmin when they among them, when follow them do the job. So therefore, they want make Oyo State and Amotekan cops make them bring in herdsmen into the Amotekan organization. Isn't that funny, ladies and gentlemen? It is very, very funny. Very, very funny. The only thing when we solve the problem once again, now to evict all the whole Fulani people, both those people when they inside city, when they sell research or they change money or they do all these things, all of them, their hand they inside. This game is a very broad game. They are all Fulani people. They are not good. A Fulani man is a Fulani man. A Fulani man is a Fulani man, ladies and gentlemen. All of them, they inside the Uluguru. Okay, now yesterday this guy, what they call Shehu Sani, the man sometimes I don't know what him be the guy problem. People feel say the man a better politician before. There are all seen as a Fulani man, a former senator. When with the Buhari don't do their wuru, they say loot money, they say collect money from one man, after they say go prison, he made this. All Nawayo, a criminal should be locked up, whether you be APC or PDP, whether you be APC shifting or PDP shifting. So far say you be looter, so far say you be corrupt government official, so far say they don't get evidence, say man, this man loot money, like me now. All those ones not go jail, ladies and gentlemen. But then they punish IPOB for nothing. You, when they take billions of dollars. In fact, you and Hesumi, now the same group of people. Because now money when belongs to the citizens. Now him, you they loot, they keep citizens. For hunger. Now, Shehu Sani come and come talk, say, make Sunday, Iboho, come Sambisa Forest, if in the claim, say, in a one man soldier. If in the claim, say, in too much, making come Sambisa Forest. But this man forgets, say, the army people in Nigeria, all of them are Fulani, why they not go inside the forest? Go fight Boko Haram. Where the whole police men, when they the northern part of the country, why they not go inside the forest? Go solve their own problem. And again, make una disease from talking about IPOB, ESN, and the Southeast government issues. Make una talk about the north when una come from. When problemful everywhere, Jabrata. So for somebody like this man, what they call Shehu Sani, to come out to the talk like that, say make Sunday Igboho leave the herdsmen when they for Oyo State, go Sambisa Forest, go attack the deadly terrorists. A crazy talk, ladies and gentlemen. I say na crazy talk. We go read that. We will see how they talk. Make one person Sunday come fight for. Where your people? Where the Buhari one are they claim? Where all those security outfit one are claim say Meyati Allah don't rule come out? Why they not go fight that fight for owner? Why come you say na Yoruba man with a call? Make you leave problem when they in land. Come they solve your own problem. So this one, this kind of talk, I don't know where it come from. So make we read a little bit. Send Fulani's herdsmen to Sambisa Forest. Sunday Igboho is busy in Southwest. FKK, now in the reply you, in the reply to waiting Shehu Sani, talk. FKK, they tell us, oh yeah, on a Fulani people, may them go Sambisa Forest, go do the fighting by themselves, because now waiting they start, so now then got to end it by themselves. We don't tell them, I say, this money, we don't know they give these people. Say this matter go big pass on her. We don't tell myself we're gonna solve this problem long time, long, long time ago. Ona refuse. Today now with the cause on the go. Chineke ga pokwa gyoko. Okay. Former Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Chief David Olawofemi Adewomi Abusalami Femi Fanikayode, has replied Senator Shehu Sani over his comment mocking the people of Southwest for depending on a popular Yoruba activist Sunday Igboho to drive out murderous Fulani herdsmen from the Southwest. Shehu Sani had in a rather mocking manner tweeted that Sunday Igboho should be invited to the north to help drive away Boko Haram from Sambisa Forest. He tweeted, invite Sunday to help drive away Boko Haram from Sambisa Forest. The tweet does not sit well with many Nigerians, especially those from the southern part of the country, including a former Minister of Aviation, Femi Fanikayode, replying to Shehu Sani's tweet. FKK tweeted, sorry, my brother, but I am sure he is far too busy cleaning and delivering the forest of the Southwest from bloodthirsty terrorists and murderous criminals. May I suggest that you send Meyati Allah, Magban, and all the Fulani herdsmen to Sambisa to help drive out Boko Haram instead. Not a thing when FKK tell Shehu Crazy Sani. How Shehu Sani will come back on the talk stage, make Sunday Igboho come to help them when Buhari did there, Gambari did there, all the whole army, all of them, na Boko Haram people, on did there. Until the one day, this Boko Haram, then go invade Asurok. Ladies and gentlemen, not be today, we don't de talk this thing. Not be today, we don't de tell them, I say, one day, this thing, when government, they take play, these people, when these same people, when they give money, we don't see now how many times where they don't ambush Governor Zulum. It suit them right. Now them be governors, now them supposed to fight the fight. So if we not fight the fight, this Boko Haram, they go continue to come until then go kidnap whoever when be on our president in Asurok. Although we know, see, if they kidnap on our president, we are not going to let the world know that one. We are not going to see either. Begin to continue manipulating. The same way when I take the manipulate before. So, ladies and gentlemen, now so the whole matter be, if the government of the day, they not stop dressing, one day, this Boko Haram people, then go sit down in Asurok there, continue to rule that country. They go just hijack that country completely. Una got to be very, very careful. Una, they trade with fire. No, they trade with fire. That is why the liberation of our people is imminent. That is why Biafra have to come soon. If you not get anything on one yarn concerning all these people, including the people from Oyo State, all those political groups where they talk, see, they won't make them bring in the Fulani herdsmen into Amotekun, including the tweet, when this man tweet now, when don't they cause big problem online regarding Sunday Boho? If you not get anything on one yarn, ladies and gentlemen, make on come here, come they tell us on a opinion. Not so the whole matter be, ladies and gentlemen. If you know, say you never subscribe to our channel before, make you begin subscribe right now. No waste time, no wait until tomorrow, just subscribe right now. Right, so see you guys next time, and God bless you as we continue to watch my program. Bye everybody from Canada. One love.